So this is just a video about CAPE, and I guess the subjects were biology, chemistry, and physics. I decided to do CAPE last year, around September. I was gonna go back to UWE, and then I found out I was pregnant with my second son. So I decided to do something that I would be able to do at home, and CAPE was something that I didn't do that I always wished that I had. I always wish that I made the decision to do CAPE in secondary school, because I tried to fast forward things by doing N1, and N1 is basically a one-year program where it's 2 years of CAPE in 1 year, which is 2 semesters. Each semester is approximately 4 months. So when I went into N1 straight from CXE, it was really difficult to catch up, because CAPE has everything spanned out. It has, it's just easier for somebody to grasp concepts in CAPE, whereas N1 is such a fast track study. So I decided to do CAPE when I found out I was pregnant. I didn't want to go back to school being pregnant, because I did that. I went to school when I was pregnant during the second semester of N1, and it was not easy. So if I did CAPE at home, I was really confused as to how to go about signing up, and my alternative paper 3, which is the alternative paper to labs, or IAs as they say. I never did that, so I did labs in N1 though, so I'm very familiar with the work and how to do labs. So I went online, and I also called Ministry of Education. They helped me. Basically, you just have to wait until they advertise. So you have to wait for the advertisement, and you have to sign up. Now, when I was gonna sign up, they said that private candidates cannot do biology, chemistry, and physics, only recent candidates. But then I called them, and I was like, I saw that biology, chemistry, and physics were only available for recent candidates, and I did not do this before, but I am familiar with the work. And they said it was an error. So then I applied. It has the information on how to apply, and I think I did a video. I might look for it and see if I can add it on to, like, how to do the envelopes and what documents you need. But it's really time consuming, but it's worth it if you want to do something at home, if you want to have something that you can study for. And the first 2 trials of CAPE is free.
What are you doing? He's sleeping.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. The baby's sleeping. Leave him, okay?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's my first son. So that's my baby that I was pregnant with when I was in the second semester N1. That made me say, I am not gonna go to school pregnant and expecting a baby again, because it's really hard. And for all those who ever done it, I give you props for that, because it's really, really hard trying to control your body and your emotions with a new baby inside of you, and still focus enough to pass your exams or even excel. So anyways, I signed up for my exams, and it was really it was a lot of runaround, but it was really easy once you follow the instructions. Just make sure you're not missing anything like I was. And if you're doing biology, chemistry, and physics, you need somebody to vouch for you that you are capable of working in a lab environment. I was lucky enough that one of my lecturers at UWE vouched for me, because my chemistry lecturer. And that was enough for the 3 subjects. So after that, I really just stayed at home. I downloaded the syllabus of biology, chemistry, and physics on my a laptop and my phone, and I just read through it. And I read textbooks that I got from friends and that I already had from Cape. And right now I did, for example, so
Mommy.
Far I did, yes baby.
Baby.
I did 3 paper 2 and 1 paper 3. And I was so shocked for paper 3 chemistry, because they were like, you could take your books and your notes with you during paper 3. And I was like, what? Because I didn't know that you were allowed.
I didn't know that you were allowed
to carry things. So... Go away. Go. Yeah, so I was like, what?
Yes.
So
what?
If I can't even make a simple video, how could I even study?
You break that.
Anyways, I think he just broke my tripod. Yeah, she just threw down my whole tripod, my everything. So, no, that's not even funny. Yeah, he almost broke my phone and then say I broke it. Anyways, so the chemistry, I was really shocked because we were allowed to take in textbooks.
Don't!
Chemistry, we were allowed to take in textbooks and notes, and one girl even had her lab manual from school because she was a recent candidate. I wish I had that. And she finished so fast because she had everything that she needed. So I hope for physics and biology it'll be the same. I didn't even bother taking my books because I didn't even think that we were allowed to take books in. So it's really good. Once you are familiar with the subjects, even at a CXE level, I think you could do CAPE at home. I don't think you need the stress of going to school. Like, yes, going to school helps and having it.
Mommy,
I'm just a learner. I can learn on my
Mommy,
own.
Mommy,
there, yeah, I'm gonna get your videos, but I can learn on my own, and there's so much resources online, so much books that you can buy. Like, if you have that independence when coming to studying, yeah, I would recommend anybody doing CAPE. But if you're just at home, because right now things are really difficult in the country, I know, and if you think that you want to upgrade, you know, your academics, you can, what am I saying? Update your and to learn something, keep your brain working, and if you want to accomplish something at the end of the day and you're home, I think you should do CAPE if you want. There's so many subjects you can do, and it can really help in the future, because you can just even become like a lessons teacher and just be a little academically independent, if you know what I mean. So, CAPE, I will be posting a video at the end of my exams just to tell you like how the whole experience has been. But if you're watching this and you really want to find out information about CAPE, I will post everything I can find that I read before I signed up, and all the people that explained how the procedure works, okay? Okay, so take care and thank you for watching, and I'm sorry about my son. Yeah, if I can make a little video explaining what I'm doing, imagine me trying to study. Mm-hmm. And then when the baby wakes, anyway, take care.